It's not the rapper's fault. You know what I'm saying? Like, listen to the beats. That's why we're left with this fucking pedantic, everything sounds the same 140 BPM shit.
140 BPM shit.
If I'm a producer and I send you a rapper 20 beats and they're all 140 BPM, is the rapper's fault that his song sounds like everyone else's? What's he supposed to do?
Now, it doesn't take too long of a search through YouTube or Google to find that there's some tension going on between old school boom bap and new school trap music under the umbrella of hip hop. Whether it's the philosophy or the music or even the lyrical techniques used in the raps, there seems to be a divergence between the two subgenres. And it's very curious because some in the old school would say that the new school trap guys, they just lost all lyricism and skill. Which can't be right. There's definitely fire bars going on in the trap music game. And then the new school guys are saying that the old guys are just not with the times, that their beats are outdated and they're stuck in the 90s, which also isn't true because there's amazing boom bap beats coming out even today. So what gives? In my opinion, I think the big dichotomy stems from the actual beats themselves. The structure of the beats demands different things from each rapper. So what's the biggest difference? Tempo. Old school boom bap beats are about 90 beats per minute, or 180 beats per minute if we think about double time, which we'll talk about. For the beat that's around 70, 73 beats per minute, there's a big delay between each beat. That's a lot of space for you to not be dropping rhymes. If we consider the fact from the last video that one of the principles of rap is to feel the four and to drop your rhymes on the count. So what happens if the beat is so slow that there's too much space in between the counts for you to wait for the next beat or the next snare even further away? Well, this is where the idea of double time comes in. By using double time, which we'll talk about, we add more structure to the beat, and this is easier to do on the trap flows. Not everyone agrees with me. Some people do believe that the standards are different.
The standard is lowered. So what you needed to get an A on the test now is lower than what you used to have to get. That's what it is. The standard is fucked up because all the dope people left.
On the other hand, if you look at two swimmers as an example, one that does freestyle swimming, the fastest kind, and the other does breaststroke swimming, another kind of swimming, we can't get mad at the breaststroke swimmer for not being as fast as the freestyle swimmer. There's different constraints, different disciplines, different arts in general, in terms of the analogy with boom bap and trap. So maybe it's just that there hasn't been enough time for the trap rapper to explore the full possibilities in terms of their rhymes in the trap style of beats. So there's a lot of triplets going on. There's a lot of mumble rapping because people like trends. But trust me, give it time and the dopest of rappers will move, not just from boom bap to trap, but the other way, and elevate the entire game as a whole. And this is what I like about Russ. You know, he took this statement and actually tried to show and prove, jumping on a Jake 1 beat that's at about 146 beats per minute, 73 beats per minute in regular time. And he does some good stuff that I think we should look carefully and analyze to learn about what we should do about slower trap tempo beats.
I'm just trying to restore the standard. I'm trying to set the bar back up.
Pulling people's cards is so cathartic. Yeah. Finished every beat for rapper started. Yeah. I swear I'm about to eat. I eat Mubarak. I see my target. I want the throne and then I'm ghost like I'm Omari Hardwick. Y'all Barney Clark. Y'all got no heart. The money's Robert Jarvik. Do a card trick. Make your queen.
So that piece of the verse was dope. A good flow, good punchlines, good rhythm. But here's one thing that I want you to notice. Notice how there's a lot of rhymes that don't land on a particular beat. For instance, Hardwick, Jarvik, Card Trick, Queen, Weak C. They're words that don't necessarily fall on the beat, which makes us think that Russ is not thinking in terms of a four count. Instead, he might be thinking in terms of double time, which is simply just doubling the speed of the beat and counting in a four count. So we'll call it four prime just to make the difference, because the numbers, because we double time, will mean something different. And now let's see, by fitting the same piece of the verse to this double time tempo, if that makes a little bit more sense with what Russ was trying to do with this verse.
Pulling people's cards is so cathartic. Yeah. Finished every beat for rapper started. Yeah. I swear I'm about to eat, I eat Mubarak. I see my target. I want the throne and then I'm ghost like I'm Omari Harwick. Y'all Barney Clark, y'all got no heart. The money's Robert Jarvik. Do a card trick, make it quick.
Now let's disregard these numbers for now. The first thing to notice is how the snare lands on the 3 now. Now that's what I mean, that the numbers mean something different. The snare used to land on the 2 and the 4, now it's landing on the 3 prime count. And the best way to visualize it is to take the clock that we saw in the last video with the 4 count inside the clock, and we're going to put 2 4 prime counts on the outside so that we can see how the numbers line up with each other in terms of meaning. We'll notice that the 3, as predicted, lines up with the 2s and 4s of the regular count. And the beats that don't fall in line with any of the old counts are the 2 prime and the 4 prime. And this is what we call the off beats. And it's focusing our rhymes to land on the off beats that makes rapping in a slower flow, in a slower tempo, a lot more appealing, as we can see in this example from the same song.
Clark, y'all got no heart, the money's Robert Jarvik. Do a card trick, make your queen just disappear. Cause I see in a week what you see in a year is brutal. The hate was futile. You Google.
Now, as we could tell, there's a lot more off rhymes in this piece of the verse than in the one before, and you feel it. Feels like you're tripping over the flow and catching yourself as we keep going. And that's what makes off beat rhyming so interesting, and it's actually a skill. It's not easy to do. Russ doesn't do it throughout the whole song. It does it maybe in 2 very discrete pieces, which goes to show that it is actually more difficult to pick the pockets of slower beats because you have to double time your flow and it adds extra structure. But this isn't a video about Russ or his opinions. This is a great introduction into the notion of double time and rhyming. And it was a great comment and example to make to stress this point. So now let's look at other artists that emphasize the offbeat rhymes. For instance, Mick Jenkins in his newer album, there's a song, Contacts. And in it is just a fascinating consistency when it comes to his use of the offbeat rhymes.
Real eyes, real lies, help me see the truth. Tryna be more James, I walk in Peter's shoes. Sparrows gotta be my views, Vince's frames, I see him through. Fear God.
All right, now let's listen to this double time.
Help me see the truth. Tryna be more James, I walk in Peter's shoes. Sparrows gotta be my views, Vince's frames, I see him through. Fear God, I'm stepping in, no weapon form. The needle move, the record scratch, the blessings pour. Almost like I'm pre-approved for everything. My credit good, my check is strong.
Now that's a remarkable consistency that's coming in terms of the on rhymes and the off rhymes. And the reason someone like Mick Jenkins is able to do this is because they have a feel for the pockets. They know where the on beats are, the traditional 4 count, and they know where they get mapped to when we talk about the double time rhymes. All 4 beats get mapped onto the 1 prime and the 3 prime, almost like they get squished from 4 numbers to 2 numbers. And that gives us 2 new open spaces. The offbeats, the 2 prime and the 4 prime, which fit nicely in between each old school beat. And it doesn't matter what visualization we use to practice these things. It could be the metronome visualization or the clock visualization. Whatever helps us notice that the 4 and the 2 prime lie in between the old school beats, and these are the in-betweens that we want to try to catch if we want to get that golden snitch, the extra points in the Quidditch game as opposed to the regular score, the regular rhymes. These are much more valuable. And if we're able to switch between the 2, we're going to have a substantial flexibility in terms of the number of beats that we'll be able to rhyme on. So let's look at this remarkable example from the soon-to-be GOAT, J. Cole.
Yeah. I don't want no picture with the president. I just want to talk to the man. Speak for the boys in a band, though. And my nigga never walking again. Apologize if I'm harping again. I know these things happen often, but I'm back on the scene. I was lost in a dream as I write this to teen down in Austin. I've been building me a house back home in the South, man. Won't believe what it's costing.
Now, that's a very consistent flow in terms of having both on rhymes and off rhymes. But let's compare this to what happens next. We're almost like a phase transition from gas to liquid flow. Cold is going to switch his entire scheme to be purely emphasizing off beats.
testing. That's why I moved away. I needed privacy, surrounded by the trees in Ivy League. Students that's recruited higher league, thinking you do you and I do me. Crib has got a big old back of yard. My niggas stand outside and pass cigars, filled with marijuana, laughing hard. Thankful that they friends a platinum star. In the driveway, there's no rapper cars, just some shit to get from back and forth.
Talk about fluid. All of the rhymes with emphasis fell on the off rhymes. And you feel it. You feel it when you listen to the song compared to what happens immediately before. It's a total switch. And so, yeah. Bam. And although to the ear it's very alluring and curious, it's really as simple as finding the pockets that matter in your beat, in this case, the 4' beat. And you can compare it to newer songs. There's a Joey Badass came out with a new couple of songs recently, and he's putting a lot of emphasis on the 2' in this case, and it's basically throughout the entire verse. So from now on, keep your ears peeled, whether it's a boom bap song with a traditional 4 count, and you can either have an odd rhythm or an even rhythm, or if we're thinking in terms of double time, the 4' count, you can either have on beats or off beats, which give us a huge range of spaces and pockets for us to land our rhymes. This channel, The Terminalia, is not just about rap. We're here to discuss learning in itself and learning how to learn. So we're going to get into jazz music theory, Brazilian jiu-jitsu. We're going to get into philosophy, mathematics, theoretical physics. We're going to go through the full gambit of the most amazing discoveries that we've made, not just intellectually, but artistically, because I believe that through the connections of these disciplines, we find the true capability to learn for ourselves and think critically about the world. So with that, subscribe, check out the next channel, check out the Terminal Rap playlist to see if I have any authority to be speaking about rap in the first place. We got a few tracks there and music videos for your viewing pleasure. And with that, thank you for watching. Peace.